Next up is this big white thing in the middle of the screen, and I'm really not trying to trick you. This is called the page, or as we'll sometimes refer to it, the document. So either the page or the document. And this is where we would type all of our information, or we would insert pictures, or we're going to learn how to do shapes. So this is where we're creating our document. So for example, I'm going to start by typing, let's go to the mall. And now when I type some information on my document, I have a part of the screen that's changed. So this gray bar that follows the bottom of our document is what we call the status bar. And it gives us the status or the current information about our document. So the first thing it's going to tell me is the number of pages in my document. So right now I'm on page 1 of 1 total pages. Next up, it's going to tell me how many words I have in my document, and I have 5. It says, let's go to the mall. Then I've got this little book right here, and it has an X, and that's because I have a proofing error. If it had a check mark, that would mean that I didn't have any grammar or spelling issues. So because it has an X, I can click on this little box, and it will bring up the spell check and the grammar, and it's telling me, hey, you spelt let's wrong. You forgot your apostrophe. So I can go through and I can check my document, and when it's good, it will tell me that I've completed my spell check. Note, now that I've finished fixing my mistake, that little box turns with a green check and it tells me I have no proofing errors. Finally, we have 2 more sections down here on the status bar, and the first are these 3 little buttons that look like different kind of books or pieces of paper. And these are our view modes. So just a reminder, if you hover your mouse over top, it will tell you what mode you're using. So the one that looks like a book is read mode. So if I click this, it will make my document look like I'm reading a book. The second one is called print layout. And this is the view mode that we're going to use the most because it will show us what our document would look like if we printed it. The last view mode is called web layout, and this would show us what our document would look like if it were on the web or on the internet. So like I said, the one we'll use the most is print layout, but do know that you can change the view and see your document in a different way. And then finally, the last thing over here on the right is our zoom button. So we can either click the minus to zoom out on our page, or we can click the plus to zoom in on our page. That means we'll see it further away or closer away. Or we can click and drag on the slider and see how that percentage changes, and it tells us when we drag out what we're viewing it at. And the last option for viewing is you can actually click on the actual percentage, and it will bring up this dialog box where you can choose a preset, or you could type in your own. So I could say, hey, I want to view it actually at 50%. And then I click OK, and it will automatically bring that to 50%.
And now that you know how Microsoft Word is kind of laid out, you're ready to actually start creating. Woo!